A reserve currency is a currency held in large quantities by central banks and institutions across the globe. It is used to participate in the global economy through facilitating international transactions or investments, only growing in importance over the years. A 2011 study found the amount of currency held in reserve increased by over 730% since 1995, from around $1.4 trillion to $10.2 trillion. As such, it is a crucial part of conducting business across borders. For example, imagine a company in India wants to do business with a company in the Philippines. They will most likely structure the deal in a reserve currency, typically the US dollar, as the dollar is easily convertible and a stable source of value. Now, before we go any further, if you're liking this video, please do consider subscribing and hitting the like button below. Now back to the video. The first currencies were precious metals, gold and silver, tradable, fungible, universally recognized and respected. However, the issue of using precious metals as reserve currency is that there is simply not enough of them to give the market enough depth and liquidity. That is why, up to World War II, the pound sterling was the world's first reserve currency during the days of the British Empire, which goes to highlight the importance of a country's political and economic influence for being a reserve currency. Towards the end of World War II, at the Bretton Woods Conference in 1944, it was clear America would emerge as a global economic superpower. It was therefore agreed that the dollar, which had been slowly increasing its share of international trade and GDP, would replace the pound as the world's reserve currency, using gold as a fixed exchange rate mechanism. The dollar was backed by gold at a rate of $32 an ounce until 1973, when President Nixon decoupled the dollar from gold and replaced it with a floating exchange rate system. Since then, we have seen the continued dominance of the dollar, albeit with the rise of the euro and the Chinese RMB as challengers. This has created interesting challenges, which will be explained later in the video. So what determines whether a currency is used as a reserve currency? Well, no rule exists stating that a currency has to be used as a reserve currency and therefore held around the world. Reserve currencies can be viewed as a byproduct of the underlying traits of their economies. Perhaps the most important trait is the size of the reserve currency's economy. How important is that economy internationally? The more important the economy, the more international trade, and therefore the more likely its currency will be held by other countries to facilitate that trade. The convertibility of the currency into domestic currencies is also important. Is the financial system set up to facilitate that conversion, which is linked to how open that country's financial markets are? Also, is that currency used in part of a currency peg? As in, do other countries try to ensure the value of their currency is kept fixed or within a certain range relative to the reserve currency? To do this, the pegging currency will need large stores of the reserve currency in reserve to buy and sell. So how do reserve currencies get used? Reserves are held by countries for a variety of reasons. They are an important indicator of ability to repay foreign debt, defend a national currency, and sovereign credit ratings. Central banks often use their reserves to defend their exchange rate, selling or buying their reserves relative to their own currency to maintain exchange rate stability. Minimizing exchange rate risk is key, as fluctuations in currency can diminish investors' returns or the value of assets within a country. What constitutes reserve currency assets then? Now, there is often a bit of confusion to what actually constitutes reserve currency. A country's reserve currency holdings do not just include cash, but include a host of other assets as well. These include sovereign debt, such as US Treasury bonds, financial securities, and loans. Therefore, when the US, for example, borrows money in the international markets, this can end up counting towards another country's foreign currency reserves. China is a good example of this, holding over $1.1 trillion of US debt. So who are the major reserve currency players then? Having discussed the traits of reserve currencies and assets, we have a much better understanding of likely candidates for reserve currency status. It will come as no surprise that the almighty dollar is the world's leading reserve currency, accounting for over 60% of the $12.3 trillion of allocated reserves as at Q1 2020, followed by the euro at 20%, the Japanese yen at 6%, and the British pound at 4.7%. Surprisingly, the Chinese RMB only accounted for 2%, or $221 billion, of reserved currency assets. This is a reflection of the dominance of the dollar, liquidity of other reserve currencies, and openness of their financial markets. However, are reserves changing? Whilst analysts agree there will be no immediate challenge to the dollar's supremacy, a growing number of commentators are coming to the conclusion that the days of dollar hegemony are likely to end in the medium term. We can define the current system as bipolar between the dollar and the euro, but strongly in favour of the dollar. The euro's share of global reserve currencies peaked in 2009 at 28%, having since declined due to the fragility exposed by the Eurozone crisis and ensuing political instability. Surprisingly though, analysts are raising the possibility of the euro replacing the dollar as the currency of choice for oil trading, implying less petrodollars and more petro-euros. But there is a substantial obstacle to widespread euro adoption: the insufficient number of euro-denominated safe assets required to replace the dollar. With the Eurozone crisis eroding the number of European countries producing assets, read sovereign debt here, that are considered safe. Moreover, and somewhat ironically, those Eurozone countries that do produce safe debt, notably Germany, don't produce enough of it. However, if the Eurozone manages to draw a line under its debt crisis once and for all, then its share may rise once again. Now, if we were to think less about absolute reserves and more about global share of GDP that each reserve currency influences, research suggests the world is already tripolar. A study by Tover and Knorr in 2018 looked at data between 2011 and 2015, finding the US's share was 40%, China's 32%, and Europe's about 19%. A much more balanced picture than absolute currency holdings. Interestingly, they found that the RMB's influence is attributed to the BRIC economies of Brazil, Russia, India, and China, more than China's surrounding Asian nations. All economies at a similar stage of economic development. A 2019 follow-up study found that the US's share had declined to 31%. China's had hovered around 30%, but the Eurozone's had increased from 19 to 27%. The remainder being unallocated. This suggests that as the dollar loses grip in the international monetary system, it will be the euro that makes up the ground. So what are the problems with the reserve currency system? A key problem with the reserve currency system is something called exorbitant privilege. As such, the dollar's dominance is said to give the US exorbitant privilege. Because other countries wish to hold the dollar, dollar demand leads to lower borrowing costs. The US is therefore able to borrow at low rates and is less worried about default. This is especially so during times of crisis, think 2008 or 2020. You see, the US's ultimate safe haven status means investors, institutions, hedge funds, practically everyone, is more than happy to park their cash in US bonds. However, the problem is that it can incentivize reserve currency countries to rack up huge amounts of debt. The US is a perfect example of this, where its national debt was an eye-watering $26.5 trillion as at July 2020, and has likely increased since. Such high levels of debt have been glossed over in recent times, but the scale of the problem is starting to draw more attention. A Goldman Sachs report has stated that there are real fears over the dollar's future as the world's reserve currency. Because of the ridiculous amount of borrowing going on at the moment, there are concerns the US is engaging in debasement of its currency, where the money printers are switched to overdrive, our old friend quantitative easing makes an appearance, and inflation rolls up. Inflation of the dollar erodes the value of each dollar in circulation, meaning holders of US debt could see their assets dwindle if inflation rises rapidly. This is considered by investors to undermine the credibility of the dollar, but the dominance of the dollar in the short term at least is unaffected. Another problem with the system is what economists call the Triffin dilemma, where the issuing reserve currency government wants cheap sources of capital, deliverable through selling currency to foreign governments via bonds. At the same time though, they want to avoid large trade deficits to instill confidence in the currency's status as a reserve currency. Unfortunately, cheap capital and positive trade balances are extremely difficult to sustain for a reserve currency issuer. And that, in a nutshell, is the Triffin dilemma. A more obscure issue is the claim that reserve currency status is a threat to national security. You see, if you issue a reserve currency, your economic policies are no longer domestic only. You have to balance your domestic economic priorities with decisions that will benefit other countries, such as exchange rates, issuing safe haven assets, and trade deficits. Given the problems with the reserve currency system, are there any alternatives? Well, yes. The IMF has created an international reserve asset called a special drawing right, or SDR. This is not a currency in its own right, but a right for its holder to draw currency issued by another IMF member. The SDR's value is determined by a basket of five currencies: the US dollar, the euro, the Japanese yen, the British pound, and the Chinese RMB, with the RMB being added in 2016 to reflect China's growing importance. This relative weighting system would go a long way to solving the problems highlighted with the current system. A key benefit would be greater stability in the international monetary system, with less exposure to US monetary policy or dollar value. But such a move to replace the dollar would need to be very carefully managed. Any decreasing demand for the dollar could impact dollar-denominated asset values across the world, undermine trade through existing contracts, and lead to higher US interest rates, threatening the sustainability of the US's large sovereign debt pile. Overall, we have seen that reserve currencies are held because of the underlying traits of their economies. The US dollar is by far the largest reserve currency in absolute terms, but is diminished in GDP impact terms. The world is likely to move to a tripolar system of the dollar, euro, and RMB. Being a reserve currency provides exorbitant privilege, but generates problems like incentivizing debt and the Triffin dilemma. And finally, the IMF's special drawing right could be considered an alternative, but any transition to a relative weighting system would need to be carefully managed to maintain stability in the dollar and US debt. As we come to the end of this video, we at Old Simplified would love to hear your thoughts on reserve currencies. Do you think a tripolar system is likely, that the RMB will replace the dollar as a reserve currency of choice anytime soon, or that the IMF's special drawing rights is the way forward? Let us know in the comments below, and if you like this video, please do give us a like and consider subscribing. See you in the next video.